Well, we hope you never need one. And too often we take paramedics for granted. Their job is brutal, with trauma and despair constant companions. So today, when a veteran of 47 years was honoured by the ambulance service, we asked Cheryl Taylor to help share his remarkable story.
Among 25 paramedics and staff honoured for service today, Inspector John Ellams, known as Herb, beginning his remarkable career with the New South Wales Ambulance back in 1965.
He was only 15 years of age, although at the time he told everybody who mattered that he was 17.
Now, I started back when we drove around in little yellow cars and with no brakes and just a stretcher and a first aid kit.
In January 1977, he was among hundreds of rescue workers at Australia's worst rail disaster. A crowded commuter train derailed at Granville. 83 people died, 200 were injured.
Granville was a challenge. It taught us a lot. We weren't prepared, we needed to do something, and all the emergency services changed after that.
Soon after, he was promoted and posted to Cooma to face on his own a terrible bus crash, and then the Strathfield massacre in 1991, a shooting rampage, 8 dead, 6 wounded and hundreds deeply scarred emotionally. Paramedics, though, rarely expose their own emotions, except to great mates, always there as a backstop.
There's times in this job when it can be quite confronting, and to have someone to be able to talk to is a lifesaver.
10 years of drug scene overdoses in Cabramatta, decades of accidents.
It's just an action-packed job, and at the same time you could save lives.
Today is the last time Herb will proudly wear the paramedic uniform, retiring officially in a few weeks. Cheryl Taylor, 10 News.